Hello, my name is Lisa, Styles by Lisa, and welcome to my curl channel. And today I'm going to be doing a tapered cut and a shortcut wash and go using my curl products. After doing a consultation with my client, she expressed to me that she wants to start to grow her hair out and she wants it to be in more of a bob shape. So I am going to start the process by shaping her hair, giving her the foundation so that she can grow it out to the shape that she desires. We also talked about how often she should come to the salon for maintenance. And I recommended that because she wants to start growing her hair out, she should come to the salon at least every 3 months to get a trim and a protein treatment as she grows her hair out to her desired length. And I also recommend that in between salon visits that she shampoos her hair at least every week or bi-weekly, deep conditioning it with our Rehydrate Intense Moisture Conditioner, sitting under a dryer for best results to help to improve the health and quality and porosity of her hair. Our Rehydrate Intense Moisture Conditioner is a salon quality conditioner that helps to repair the hair strength and helps the hair to better retain moisture, which is exactly what our hair needs. So after I've done the cut, I wet her hair down and I'm using our Moist Restore Leave-In Conditioner. And I am distributing it throughout the hair evenly, making sure that it's detangled and prepared for our next product, which is our curl foaming mousse. With the curl foaming mousse, I'm going to use about a quarter size to two quarter size, primarily focusing on the ends. I didn't really want to put a lot of the curl foaming mousse on her hair. I wanted to make sure that the extra curls that I'm going to use is the product that she has more of on her hair so that her hair has a good amount of curl definition and hold. And I am starting around the edges. I really want to make sure that her short tapered section is defined with nice hold and shine. So I'm taking the extra curls and I'm applying it using my fingers, making sure that I am applying the products from the root to the ends and basically just, finger styling the whole perimeter shorter section of her hair. These products work great. They work great with on wet hair, so you want to make sure that you keep the hair wet and dampened as you apply the products because it helps it to absorb better into the hair. You kind of just finger styling it and kind of just feeling how it feels. I'm just gonna kind of clean up her edges just to make sure that it's neat, because I feel that the neckline is the sexiest part of a shortcut, and it should be very neatly designed to complement. Then I'm going to take the extra curls and I'm going to finger style it into the entire hair, taking small sections as I go. So I'm keeping the hair wet. I've applied the mousse. And so then I'm using the majority of the extra curls to define her curls. And as you can see, I'm taking about 1.5 to 2 inch sections, making sure it's wet, and then taking my fingers and applying the products from root to end. You can also do finger coils with this product, and also you can do 2-strand twists. Same process, sectioning, wetting, same amount of products, and applying the product from root to end, and either twist, finger style, or coil twist. And as you're styling, you want to, you know, make sure that you decide where you want your part, whether or not you want it to fall forward or backward. And basically, it's just, it's not a difficult process. And if you take your time and you section your hair and you apply the products, it should come out perfect. So she decided that she wants to wear her hair falling forward. So I am over directing, starting at the top center, and I'm going to define the top part of her hair falling forward. She wants it to fall like a bang. But if you want it to fall backward, you can style it going backward. You should decide how you want it to fall and decide where you want your part before you start applying your sections, so that when it dries in the you know, direction in the way that you want it to fall. Although, I mean, you can move it, you know, once it's dry, but it's easier if you style it with the parting and the direction that you want to style before you dry it. A lot of people ask, is it necessary to sit under the dryer? It isn't necessary to sit under a dryer, and it definitely depends on the person's texture. If you have a texture, you know, where low porosity and the hair, you know, may, you know, have trouble holding, you know, and you really need to, you know, put the product on and then dry it so that it'll hold better, then you should sit under the dryer. But if you, you know, your curls are, you know, you wear wash and goes all the time, and, you know, your curls are, you know, the porosity is good and your curls are, you know, popping and things, you can, you know, put the products in and, you know, you can definitely air dry. But I definitely recommend that you dry at least a little bit with a diffuser or sitting under a hooded dryer for best results, because drying the hair all the way through deep, you know, into the, you know, cuticles is best, because it helps the hair to the hairstyle to last longer. So I've done her, you know, application, and I'm going to sit her under a dryer, and she'll be under a dryer for about 30 to 45 minutes. I give the client the option, you know, if they want to me to lift it out and pull it out, then I, you know, recommend that they sit under completely until it dries. Her hair was still a little bit wet at the roots, so I pulled it out a little just for, you know, to show you how it looks on video. And then, of course, you know, as her hair dries the next day, and then especially when she wears her scrunchies, you would use scrunchies at night, satin scrunchies in a bonnet. It also gives it lift and definition, and this should last her for about a week or two. And if she wanted to refresh, she would just add water. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to our channel. And if you want to know anything about our products, visit our site, microproducts.com.